Alright guys, sorry about the longer gap between uploads and kind of crappier footage. We're in the process of moving. We went from moving to not moving to moving to not moving in a short period of time, so it's having to go pretty quick. Local guard was still going to sell most of his collection. I picked out some pieces. He was kind of high on price, so I kind of had to pick and choose. I ended up getting everything here for $625. Some PS2 games, the One Piece games, and Shadow Realm, Breaking the Rules on GameCube, Mario Sunshine, Pikmin, Tasmanian Devil, Mario Maker, Odyssey, Link's Awakening, Breath of the Wild, Yoshi's Crafted World, Luigi's Mansion, Sonic Classic Collection, Mario Party DS, and then three games and custom Game Boy artwork cases are pretty cool. Zelda Phantom Hourglass, then we have Sylvester and Tweety, World of Illusion, Mario Kart, Super Mario Party, New Super Mario Bros., Hunter of the Wayward, Super Monkey Ball, Zelda Collector's Edition, Sonic 2 Battle, Bird's Nightmare, South Park, GoldenEye, WrestleMania, Street Fighter 2 Turbo, Kiwi Craze, and the two games I'm keeping, NCAA Football 14, and Naruto Uzumaki Chronicles 2. So I've been in a real urge to play some college football lately, and it's a Naruto game I don't have, so I'm going to keep these. Already made some profit on this stuff, so not too bad. Stay tuned for more, guys. All right, guys, picked up a lot, paid $80. Came with two PS3s, four third-party controllers, sadly all third-party. Following games, Black Ops 1 and 2 is not bad. Minecraft, Last of Us, great game, just not much value. Normal copy of Black Ops 2. Amazing Spider-Man, which is like $25. Some more filler but fun titles there. We have Transformers War for Cybertron, which is like $50. Then we have some more filler titles there, and some more filler titles here. Not the greatest lot, but for the price, really good value. Can't beat it. Stay tuned for more, guys. All right, guys, let's go over some pickups. It's been a few days. I haven't really got to show off. I am in the process of moving, so it's kind of going to what I haven't been on a show. This lot paid $204. When it comes to the games, the notable ones, Pokemon Pearl, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Pokemon Sapphire, I believe were all the noticeable ones. Yes, then some filler titles. As you can see through there, Crash and Power Rangers aren't bad when it comes to fun, but not necessarily valuable. Then we also have Cooking Mama, Brain Age, and Wild West 3D. Comes with a 3DS complete in box. There's the 3DS console itself. That also came with a red DS Lite and a blue DS Lite. And it also came with a silver Game Boy Advance. I just went through and it wasn't in there. I messaged the seller. Hopefully they can get back to me with that. This slot had a Wii with it. The Wii already sold. It was $40 is what I paid for it. Came with Wii Sports. No, Wii Sports Resort. The Wii Sports Resort, Wii Sports Double Disc. Be on the lookout for that one, guys. That's like a $45 to $50 disc there. And then Wii Sports itself. Then we have Wii Love Golf. New Super Mario Bros. That feels a little light. Okay, it's in there. And the Secret Rings. All that was $40, and like I said, the Wii already sold for $30. This lot came with a white Wii U, N64, two Xboxes, a Sega Genesis, and two GameCubes, and a PSP that's wrecked. Oh, and this Game Boy Pocket. And it was, came out to like a little over $500 because I bought some more stuff over there. Got Hit and Run for The Simpsons. That's one of the better titles here. Bass Hunter, Bart vs. the World, Lion King, Zelda DX. Have a Wavebird adapter. A couple extra controllers there. WWF No Mercy, Deck 64, NASCAR 99, Mario Kart 64, Real Monsters, Power Rangers Mighty Morphins, Battle Clash. We have Mario Paint, Yoshi Island, Legends of the Link to the Past, Super Mario All-Stars, Lost Vikings, which is the best one in the slot. It's about $75, so stay on the lookout for that. Super Mario Kart, another copy of All-Stars, Speedy Gonzales, Warlock, Spectra, and Tom and Jerry. It also came with a little carrying case full of Switch games. Better ones being Mario Maker 2, we have Mario Kart, Mario Odyssey, Pokemon Sword, also Minecraft, stuff like that in there. Let me clear this stuff off and I have some more to show you. All right, guys, for this lot, we have the Ice Blue N64 with expansion, matching controller and an extra controller and all the cords. We have Turok 2, a repo copy of Paper Mario, Rampage World Tour, Mario Party 3, Donkey Kong 64, Zelda Ocarina of Time, Pokemon Stadium, Super Mario 64, a Japanese copy of Ogre Battle, Shadows of the Empire, and Smash Bros. That lot was $200 with a pop. It was the Bob Barker Adam Sandler pop, which I did sell that for $40. So basically $160 for that. I don't even remember what I paid on this lot. We have a deal 3DS. Yeah, I don't remember this lot at all, guys. I am sorry. Looks like a bunch of just crappy games. We have a maroon DSi XL. Oh yeah, this one's got a broke. Okay, I paid $60 for this lot. The DSi XL has a broken hinge and the top's a little funky. Teal 3DS works fine. It comes with a charger for both and a ton of just crap titles. But for $60, still a really good deal. And let me clear this out, and I have one more lot to show you. And last but not least, for the lots I've been picking up, paid $100 for this lot. Came with the Sega control stick and the Sega 3D glasses for the Master System. Both complete boxes, not something I come across all the time, so that's pretty cool. A copy of Battleship for the Genesis, sealed, which is pretty cool. Then we have Choplifter for Master System, Battleship, complete Zack Sawin 3D, Shooting Gallery, Hang On Safari, Outrun, and Marksman / Trap Shooting for the Master System as well. Paid $100 for all that, so a really good deal there. And that's got up now. I was buying all those while moving, so I didn't really have time to show them. And I have a little weird area setting up my new on our new apartment. I'll show you a tour here as soon as I can, guys. Stay tuned.